Good morning, this is Master Castillo here from Maximum Martial Arts University, the place where you come to not only be a wonderful martial artist, but a great person at the same time. Now this morning what we're going to be doing is we're going to be covering hand conditioning. Now in the previous video, we talked about it on the knife hand video, that you have to develop the musculature around your hand, completely in your hand and around your hand, with the connective tissue from your forearm to your hand and inside of your hand. So an exercise like this right here for 5 minutes straight, doing this over and over, flipping out and then tucking tight back in, and just doing this in different positions all the way around, everywhere you can for 5 minutes straight, is going to help get that connective tissue and your hand stronger, okay? If you don't have the musculature to protect your bone, then this conditioning is basically worthless. Now, what is conditioning, okay? A couple things. I want to, number one, we'll go off of what everybody else says, is they are doing small little micro fractures to cause your body to end up healing itself in kind of like a honeycomb format. The bones to, you know, do microfractures and then heal themselves in a honeycomb format, creating a denser bone so that way you can hit harder. Is this true? Yes, kind of, okay? And what I mean by that is that as if I punch this pole over and over and over again, are my bones going to get stronger? Yeah, maybe, okay? Yeah, I'm going to create some grafting happening with the healing process. If I rest, if I have a really good diet, and if I already have musculature to go around it, and also if my bones don't have a pre-existing condition or like osteoporosis, okay? Yeah, but on the other end of it, is it going to be like so extensive that it's going to make you some Superman by hitting something over and over and over again? I'll ask you this question. Have you ever seen somebody that conditions and they exercise all the time, but they're conditioning on a pole, and they're saying that their muscles are getting denser? If we understand anything about density, we think about something that's this big right here that is made out of denim and rice, and we take something this big and we make it out of lead. The one thing that's made out of lead is going to be 20 times heavier than this thing. So is the person gaining lots of weight? If their bones are getting that much denser, they should be gaining lots of weight. Nope. So it's not all that, okay? But here's the next thing. When we are conditioning, what we're learning to do is to let our mind and our body and our mind communicate with each other, okay? It's our nervous system. Basically, you know, when people hit with their knife hand specifically, going for like brick breaking and stuff like that, they go like this, ah! And they bounce off. Because your mind has not communicated with your body saying, this is normal, it's all right. It's like kicking with your legs, hitting with your shins, hitting with your elbows. It's the same thing. I want to get that communication, okay? So I'm going to constantly communicate with my body and my mind, okay, with the nervous system, firing back and forth, saying this is all right, so I don't pull back and I can actually drive through. Okay, now with that being said, what we do is I take a bag like this. I've had this made specifically for myself, and basically it's a denim bag. I like the denim because it does create some, what is it called? I get calluses on my knuckles, along my hand here, along my palms here, right here this way, right here this way, so on and so forth. You get those calluses and build those up. But also, I can move it around and I can flip it over. Now, why rice? Because it's not too hard. I'm not trying to damage my hand, I'm trying to condition it, okay? So I'll start off with punching. So remember I told you guys, straight lines. Make sure that you are tucking in tight and then squeezing. Now I have that musculature that's making this a line from here to here, and I'm just practicing this over and over and over again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Ooh, it's starting to push in on this side. Flip it, do it again. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. And the reason why I like this rice bag is because it's not exactly even, okay? It's just like a body, right? The body folds in, and because the body folds in, if you don't hit with the right structure, with the right trajectory and the right alignment or the kinetic chain, then your wrist is going to bend and now you're not going to be conditioned. Okay, so I'll do that, you know, about 15 times and 15 times, and then I'll shake it out and I'll do it again another 15 times, right? One, two, and notice that I'm not blasting hard. That's not the idea. The idea is to let this communication happen between my mind and my body, and then let my body feel the stacking of my bones, that kinetic chain. Okay, and then I start to feel like pain points. Like on that last hit, I hit just a little bit further over here and I could feel that, ooh, it wasn't stacked just right, okay? And so I know that, so I need to make sure that my hand is just a little bit more focused on that index knuckle and not the first two. So those are great things about conditioning. It's not just conditioning, this is mental analysis of how we're hitting. So then we go into knife hand, it's the same thing. And notice that I'm not killing it. And you guys can hit even softer than this if you want, okay? And then we do the other side, same thing. Okay, and you can do back fist right here. You can do palm strikes right here. You can do ridge hands right here. Watch your elbow though, okay? Be very, very careful for your elbow. Okay, but the idea is that when we're doing conditioning like this, we are making communication between our body and our mind. Now, is this going to cause some damage to my body? Yes. So should I do this every day? Absolutely not. Do not do it every day, okay? You still need to have rest, a good diet, and a good exercise plan. And then I do this, me personally, maybe like at this point, once a month, okay? I do not need to be walking around with stupid, ridiculous, huge calluses over my hand. Number one, I wanna be able to caress my wife, right? Just be like, honey, it's all right. And if I have calluses over my hand and I'm ripping her face off every time I touch her, then she's not gonna like me, number one. Okay, number two, I don't wanna create an arthritic hand, right? So I don't want to be blasting my hand into the oblivion to where I have arthritis. I've seen a lot of grandmasters like this, and they're walking around and they have arthritis in their hands. I've even seen some where they wake up in the morning and they're standing up looking like this right here, and they'd have to take some painkillers, some herbal Chinese medicine, and then it takes them about 45 minutes before they can stand up straight, okay? Because they've conditioned their body to be awesome weapons. Well, are you an awesome weapon when you're hunched over? Nope, because you're so arthritic. So the idea is that we make our hand communicate with our mind, basically our body communicating with our mind, saying that this is all right, this is all right, this is all right, okay? And so on and so forth. This is all right.